Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. As a reminder, we can hopefully expect the next Starlink mission to launch this week. The Starlink 6-3 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 19th at 4:10am UTC or 12:10am EDT. In addition to that, there is also another launch scheduled for later that same day. The OneWeb 19 and Iridium 9 mission is scheduled for Friday 19th at 12:18pm UTC or 8:18am EDT. Plus, there is a crewed mission that we can hopefully expect to see a bit later in the week. The AX2 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 21st at 9:37pm UTC or 5:37pm EDT. Then, just a matter of hours after the AX2 mission, we could also see another Falcon 9 mission. The Badr 8 mission is currently scheduled for Monday 22nd at 3:20am UTC or Sunday 21st at 11:20pm EDT. There was a tweet posted about the possibility of SpaceX doing RTLS landings for boosters on crewed missions. It says, in a press briefing previewing the AX2 mission, SpaceX's Bill Gerstenmaier says Falcon 9 rockets for future crewed missions beginning with AX2 will have ability to land boosters back at the launch site. They previously had to land on a drone ship after launching crew missions. There was also another tweet posted saying Gerst added that SpaceX is in the process of certifying Falcon 9 boosters for up to 20 flights on Starlink missions. Polaris posted a tweet saying EVA training continues this month for the Polaris Dawn crew at SpaceX's headquarters in Hawthorne, California. There was a tweet posted by Michael Sheets related to Kathy Luders, who is or was leading NASA's human spaceflight program. It says Kathy Luders, former top NASA human spaceflight official, joined SpaceX according to CNBC sources. Luders is based at Starbase in Texas and will report directly to President and COO Gwynn Shotwell. Heading to Boca Chica, foundation work continues beneath the orbital launch mount. There were some pieces for a crane spotted being delivered to the production site. Here's how the new high bay sections are progressing. They're progressing very fast. There was an interesting aerial shot posted on Twitter of the water-cooled steel plates. It says the water-cooled steel plate assembly is underway. There was an interesting tweet posted related to NASA possibly considering to bypass Orion and Gateway to use just Starship. It says, I'm impressed that someone in this NASA Advisory Council Human Exploration and Operations Committee asked if NASA would consider bypassing Orion and Gateway and simply using SpaceX's Starship to take astronauts from the Earth to the Moon and back. The response? Maybe. Jeff Faust posted a tweet related to information about the interior of the Starship lunar lander. He said, speaking at the Humans to Mars Summit, Nick Cummings of SpaceX says the crew deck for its Starship lunar lander is twice the size of this stage, a large stage in an auditorium with room for multiple decks. Below it, two airlocks. There was a document posted by the FCC on their website related to communications for the second Starship flight test. Zach Golden posted a tweet with a video from Lab Padre about a possible flight termination system test at Starbase. It says it appears that SpaceX may have performed a flight termination test on the Booster 6 test article. This rupture occurred near the Common Dome. The test article was filled with water and likely pressurized to flight loads. No way to confirm the details yet. Here's another look at that B6 test tank. Starship 25 was recently seen being prepared to be transported. Here's a view of Ship 29 on the left and Ship 28 on the right in the high bay. Ship 29 was seen rotated again as they construct it. Here's a view of Booster 9 still sitting in the mega bay. Last video we saw a temporary road closure scheduled for Monday that was cancelled, then they had Tuesday which was also cancelled. So, they currently still have a temporary closure for today, Wednesday 17th. I believe this is to transport the Starship 25 prototype. To finish up the video today, there's an updated Starship production diagram thanks to the Ring Watchers. For the video today, I have to say thank you to Chris Kleindl for being out there filming the Boca Chica content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.